Hello friends, I am Siddharth and today I am going to talk about the dividend distribution tax. I'll give you a small example. Around 6 months back, I invested into an equity mutual fund scheme. And around 1 month back, that scheme declared a dividend of rupees 2 per unit. I had 1000 units in my account. So does that mean that I will be getting 2 rupees into 1000 units, that is 2000 rupees straight into my bank account? No, it is not that, because government has made some rule, I mean to say SEBI has made some rule along with the income tax department, that whenever a mutual fund company declares a dividend to me the investor, or for that matter to you the investor, they will deduct some tax at the source only, then they will pay you the rest of the amount. So out of this rupees 2, they will deduct some tax known as the dividend distribution tax and pay me the rest. That is what I am going to get. So what is the rules? What is the percentage here? Let us learn about that. Since this is an equity scheme, in the case of an equity oriented mutual fund scheme, the rule says that the AMC will deduct 10% as the dividend distribution tax, plus 12% surcharge, plus 4% health and education cess. So that makes it what? 10% DDT plus 12% surcharge plus 4% health and education cess. Together it comes to 11.60% total of tax. So 2 rupees into 11.60%, whatever is the amount, that much amount will be deducted from rupees 2, and balance I will get as tax free in my hands. So dividend distribution tax is applicable in this manner. It is first deducted and balance is paid to the investor tax free. But what could have happened if this scheme would have been a debt oriented mutual fund scheme? Assuming this scheme is a debt oriented mutual fund scheme, then this scheme might have declared a dividend of rupees 1 per unit. Again, in this example also I will be taking that I have 1000 units in my account. So does that mean that 1 rupees into 1000 is equal to 1000 rupees I will be getting straight credited into my bank account? Of course not, because here also there is a dividend distribution tax. Now herein the rule says that the dividend distribution tax is 25% plus 12% surcharge plus 4% health and education cess. So together if you add it, 25% plus 12% plus 4%, it will come to 29% total tax. So 29% of rupees 1 will be deducted at source. This is known as the dividend distribution tax along with the surcharges, and the balance I will get in my bank account as tax free. But actually it is not tax free. So tax, instead of you the taxpayer paying it, government has made it mandatory that the AMC will deduct the tax at source. It is a type of the TDS, but not the exact TDS. So you cannot claim any credit for it when you file your income tax return. Please remember that. It is very simple concept. Since people earlier, way back in 2004-2005, when these rules were made for the dividend distribution tax, people were not paying tax on the dividend received. So that's the time when government made it mandatory that okay, we will ask the AMCs, we will make the rules such that the DDT will be deducted at source before giving to you the investor. So that's why it is getting deducted, irrespective of your tax bracket, irrespective of your taxability status, whether income is taxable or not, the DDT will be there if you invest into the dividend option of a equity scheme or a debt scheme for that matter. Whatever rules I have explained, whatever tax rates I have explained, these are applicable only to the dividend option of a equity or a debt mutual fund scheme. These are not applicable to the growth option in an equity scheme or a debt scheme for that matter. Therein we have simple long term and short term capital gains tax rules, about which I have already talked in some separate videos. You might like to have a look on those videos as well. So choose your option carefully, my friends. If you go for growth option, then you will have to pay long term or short term capital gains tax. But if you go for dividend option, you will get some dividend, then these rules will come into picture. That is the rules about the dividend distribution tax. I hope, my friends, that you have understood this concept of DDT and what is this all about and how is this calculated. Thank you. See you in the next video.